Can you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
I can hear you, yeah.
Okay, just checking.
Really? Again? Oh man, I hope I realize this next month. I'm playing the wrong black and white again.
I thought you were doing that for the purpose of, you know.
Yeah. Look for the... Okay, there we go. Ellen Diaz.
That's what I said. I thought that was the point. We were joking around about this all the time.
Yeah, indeed. Because I've always mentioned this. Like, whenever I talk to people about the other black and white.
Black and white, they assume it's this one. Nope. Nope.
No,
nope.
Of course not. All right. Of course, I forgot. Oh man, I need to remember saying no about Sea Gear. But yeah, now we have a Reshiram to deal with.
Or do we?
Who knows? So yeah, I think it's off to the next gym, right?
Yeah, the next gym is in this... Yeah, the next gym,
It's in the path I was taking, right?
Yes. Yeah, the path you were taking, that takes you to Route 9, and Route 9 takes you to Opelucid, where the next gym is.
I just realized...
Or rather, where the last gym is, I should say.
Am I a bit under level for the last gym, and also... Who's gonna be the MVP for that? Cause I know I don't have any ice moves or dragon moves.
Oh yeah, that's right! We're gonna be teaching Peanut.
Teaching him what?
Blizzard.
Oh, did we already get that?
No, I think it's coming up ahead in the department store.
Oh, okay.
Oh, no, wait. Did we pass it? Let me see.
And now I'm trying to remember where I went last time. Get away. Jeez, man. Alright, got away safely.
Oh, looked like I was wrong.
What's up?
In the city you were just in.
Oh, the town with the ice gym leader?
Yeah. In the Pokemon, you know how the shops are in the Pokemon Center?
Yeah.
You talk to the guy at the one counter. Yeah, he has the Blizzard PM for sale.
Alright, let me do that real quick.
You should have more than enough for it. Insert laughter here.
Thank you. Yep. Oh, I don't have enough. Sure, I picked up some stardust, though. Not sufficient enough. Wait, Star Beast? I could sell a Star Beast for 98,000, 9,800. Jeez. Should I sell that? Soggy? I guess I'll sell it now. Peanut Blizzard.
Sorry about that.
That's okay. And which move should I get rid of?
Blizzard?
Yeah.
Let's see, what does he have?
Revenge / Surf and Aqua Jet.
Probably Aqua Jet, because you don't need two water type moves.
Alright.
Yeah. I know you're gonna have to constantly go back to heal because it only has 5 PP, but this is the best we can do.
Yep, indeed. But yeah, now let's head to,
I'm referring to the blatantly obvious fact that Ice Beam isn't available during the main story.
Right. That's a bit silly, I'd say.
Yeah, well, hey, I'm not the one who makes this stuff up.
I got Facade! Masculine. Masculine. I'm gonna use Tobey Maguire for this one. Don't react like that. Type.
I I guess the question is, what do you expect, considering this is a water route?
Right. Bruh, just wasted all my ominous wins. Jeez. Okay, is that enough protect? Oh, thank God that failed that time.
Well, yeah, it fails after repeated use.
And now it's using something else other than water than protect.
Well, what, did it use aqua ring?
Yep. Soap.
Oh, soak turns you into water type. That's great.
Isn't that a good thing, though?
Yes and no. Gets rid of your same type of attack bonus.
Yeah, I see how it is. Well, since I'm out of moves, like attack moves for etc., let's switch to Tobey Maguire for this.
Well.
It's Move Rock? Not bad.
Yeah, if you come back at different times of day, she'll give you different weather extending rocks.
Oh, we gotta go to the desert resort. Usagi?
What? Oh, the resort desert? I don't know.
Well, they...
I thought you had to go into the city first and talk to the gym leader.
Nope, apparently we gotta go. They were talking about earlier about the desert resort. An odd moment. This game is giving me some, like, at least the first half of my college years nostalgia. Come on, man!
Yeah. Oh yeah, this is the point where you have to go throughout the you have to go all the way down to the Relic Castle and,
Wait.
Yeah.
Where is Relic Castle?
It's in the desert resort. Remember where we got Setra at?
Oh yeah, that one. I almost thought he was gonna fight me, but okay. No, I will say this, unrelated to Pokemon. I've been really enjoying doing my Majora's Mask playthrough.
You know where you got the fossil?
Yeah, I know. Is it that point?
Yes.
Okay. Well, yeah, I'm at like the third region now in Majora's Mask, Soggy.
Ah, well, that's nice. Oh, or maybe I'm getting ahead of myself. Let me see.
I'm pretty sure it might be. Oh. Oh, there we go. I have to turn on some repels again. Hang on. I gotta be right back real quick. Hang on. Sorry about that. Still around?
Yep. Well, it looks like I was right. It says in Gold PDF, after Enda has awakened, Rusher M at Dragon Spiral Tower The next few floors have been cleared up, allowing the player to venture deeper into the castle, which at this point is filled with Team Plasma Grunts.
Alright. The third time in a row, my parents interrupt my life streams, and of course I forgot to change the title too. How could I forget to do something like that?
You tell me.
Remind me again, how do you get past this? Soggy?
No, what you do is instead of trying to go down the quicksand, you just go down the stairs.
That's literally what I'm trying to do.
Well, that's because you can't use the bike. You have to do it, you can't be riding the bike. You have to do it, you have to, like, just be walking.
So no running or all that?
No, because if you run and stuff, you're gonna fall down the hole. So get off the bike.
I just did, jeez. That the full title too.
So I was right the first time. You have to keep in mind, it's been, gosh, at least 2 years since I played this last. At least.
Well, it's been like 10 years for me. Well, at least when I started this. Watchhog is down. Now for the Croaker Rock. Or Crockle Rock. Idea against a dark type. So I just realized, since he's flying, and rock types are weak against ground types, I just realized he's immune to ground attacks. That's pretty interesting. Max potion. Okay. Okay. Super Fang. Yep, I am. You know, I will say this. You gotta love this rhetoric Team Galactic is having about how we should liberate all
plasma.
Plasma, yeah. Wait, what did I say?
You said Team Galactic.
Oh, whoops. Yeah, about Team Plasma. You gotta love how they want to liberate all Pokemon, but they're using them anyway.
And like I was trying to say, that's not exactly what they stand for, but they don't know it.
What is that thing?
Hey. You're gonna have to give me a second to look at it.
Alright.
To catch up. Talking about Garbodor?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a pure poison type. Evolve from a Trubbish.
Yeah, I know that, but that thing is hideous.
I don't think it's that hideous. But then again, I suppose the reason I don't think it's hideous is because I know what this thing can pull off despite how it looks.
What can it pull off?
It's ridiculously bulky.
So, oh, yes!
So it's really good at running stall sets.
Soggy,
yes?
Which one should I get rid of Shadow Ball?
I'd say override Ominous Wind.
Oh, time, man! I know that's like the standard ghost move, too.
Yes. The de facto one, yes.
An extra Shadow Ball. Okay. My question is, can anyone else even learn that?
What, Shadow Ball?
Yeah, at least in my team.
That's a good question. The answer to your question, no.
Oh man. But I will say, those were the days. I love how I just sing that every time Archie Bunker wins a fight.
Well, why not, right?
Oh. Okay, so I guess I gotta go down into one of these pits. Thank you. But yeah, wouldn't Archie Bunker be also immune to ground attacks? And he's supposed to be weak against those too.
Well, he isn't because of his partial flying type.
Yeah. At least everyone's now level 39. Come to think of it, at least the grind for like the Elite Four would be pretty easy.
Yeah. I mean, you're not too far off because most of the gym leader trainers Pokemon are in their early 40s. So it's not like you're terribly underleveled.
What about the Elite Four? What's their level range? Or at least, what's the recommended level you'd say against them?
50 at the minimum.
Okay. I mean, with the Lucky Egg, it's gonna help a lot.
Yeah, well, I'm just saying. Because a lot of their Pokemon are in the low to mid 50s. Oh, wait a minute, I just realized something.
Yeah,
a lot of their Pokemon are in the low to mid 50s. The problem is...
Problem is what?
Game, you don't, you know, in this game, you, do you know the champion that's been going around?
Yeah, what about him?
You don't actually fight him the first time.
Alright. What's Dennis's level range then?
What's N's level range?
Not just him, but I also mean Dennis, because isn't he, like, the final boss?
Technically no.
Wait, Gethys isn't?
Nope.
Wait, who is it then?
You'll see.
Okay, then. Oh my god! Still acting like PETA, are they?
Yeah, they are, but they are, but they aren't at the same time. It'll make sense when you get to Dennis.
Okay. Dennis the Menace.
Hey, you've been calling him Dennis.
I know that. Endeavor, should I teach Archie Bunker that?
No, I don't think that's necessary. I mean, he's not... I don't think we've ever had him in defeatist range, so Endeavor really isn't that useful.
Ah, okay. Other Trubbish.
Yeah. I mean, Duke can take it out on his own easy.
Yeah, because poison is weak against ground.
Yeah, and steel resists poison.
Exactly. But yeah, remember when I was talking about how I was gonna go for a pure, like a one-type challenge?
Yeah, a monotype challenge. Yeah, we were talking about that.
Yeah, I was thinking of doing that for Sapphire. No, just to do a little something different, rather than just the same balanced team.
True. I mean, you can make a balanced team out of monotype, it's just it takes more strategy.
Right. Sunstone? So I've been thinking of, like, what type I'd pick. Would it be, like, water? Ghost? Because I know there aren't many ghosts.
There aren't enough... Yeah, in Gen 3, there aren't enough ghost types to make a decent monotype team, unfortunately.
Yeah, there's only, like, Sableye, Bennett, Dusclops, and that's pretty much it. Yeah, I see how it is. I gotta change the type, the party member real quick. Like thinking, I wonder if it will be a lot more fun to do with a type I don't really care for. It isn't fairy, of course.
It depends, I guess.
Well, I meant like if it, because I know fairy types didn't appear until Gen 6.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but even if you were to do Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl, there still aren't a lot of fairy types.
Yeah, unless you count Cute Wolf Snowball post game.
Well, I'm saying even if you,
I'm gonna turn on repels again. So, remind me again, what's the plan of getting all the first four gen Pokemon into the game? I know they have like an app about to go live soon, right?
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple ways you could go about it. You could transfer the game, you could have your game have a randomizer, a randomizer wouldn't give you the right Pokemon.
I mean, you could trade them via randomizer, though.
Yeah, like, you could get them from random people, yeah, but, I mean, or if you really want, like, for example, if you were doing it for BDSP, I could probably breed most of them for you and just send them to you as eggs. Raggy.
Level 40 now?
So we're getting there.
Yep. Which is a peanut for this one.
So I guess what I'm trying to say is I highly doubt you're going to be underleveled for the gym.
Alright. Meanwhile, I'm just doing all this. All this. I'm just gonna look at the Hoenn Pokédex.
Oh, you want to do it in Hoenn, so then yeah, you wouldn't be able to do fairy types then.
Yeah, I was trying to tell you, I want to do it in Sapphire. Mm-hmm. It's a part of me would just, because obviously one, Gen 3, fanboyism, and two, unlike with the later games, at least there's a different story too compared to Ruby. I was thinking of like doing a bug type challenge, but I feel like that's a bad idea.
It's more difficult to do than a bad idea.
Right.
Like, it's not a bad idea, it's just hard to do.
Yeah, especially with the first gym leader, Roxanne. See if I started with like Vorchick. I know there's some fair like fire types like Camera, Macargo, Torkoal.
Yeah, but I don't know if it's enough to make a team. Let's see.
Not really, to be honest. Try another one. Unless we start with grass type like Sceptile, Ludicolo, Breloom. What's up?
Yeah, you're right. So for Sapphire, it would be Sceptile, Ludicolo, Breloom,
Vileplume, and Bellossom. And Cacturne, which is pretty cool. And Cradilly as well.
I think that's more than six.
Hmm.
So you'd probably have to... Or you could use Roselia if you'd rather have a grass poison type.
Right.
Although, I don't know. I don't think that's interesting to you because, you know, this is before it got an evolution.
Yeah, there's Roserade. I mean, I could do a type something based on my avatar, though. And let's see what we can guess what it is. Because, you know, I'm a wizard. And what
yes,
would fit in...
I know
in...
what you're talking about. Let me see what we got.
So psychic types, that... you know? You know?
So, yeah, you're talking about the dark type, correct?
No, psychic types.
Oh.
Well, we went with, like... Is there such a challenge like that? Like a dual type?
Well, people use dual type... in single and monotype runs.
Well,
people use dual types.
No, I mean like two different types, like dark and psychic.
No.
Yes.
Not that I've seen. It's usually only a monotype.
Alright.
But so, as for psychic, let's see. So you'd have...
Gardevoir.
You'd have Gardevoir. Alakazam.
Medicham.
Yeah, Medicham, let's see what else. Grumpig.
Whoa, Grumpig. So that's four,
and
right?
Lunatone.
Oh, yeah. And Claydol.
Yeah, Claydol.
And Chimecho.
Chimecho. I mean, you could, or...
Wobba. Oh, Zatu! That's a good
one. You could, or you could... Staryu's in the regional, Staryu's in Hoenn's decks.
There's that, too.
And, you know, when it evolves to Starmie, it becomes a water psychic.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Or I guess you could, or you could use the why not egg that you get and hatch it into a Wobbuffet.
Is Wobbuffet even good? Because is he broken in a good way or in a bad way?
To be honest, it's not too good in a story playthrough because you have no idea what
So basically,
is going to choose. So probably not the best idea, but you're right, Natu's in there. And Giraffe Rig.
Those are like Safari Zone too.
And we're not counting the legendaries, and we're not counting Beldum because that's post game.
Yeah.
And we're not counting any legendaries or mythicals, and we're not counting Beldum because it's post game, unfortunately. So that leaves us with 1, 2, 3.
I think I already have an idea of what I want, though. So Gardevoir.
6, 7. Yeah, we have way more than 6 to choose from.
Yeah, so I have an idea of what I want personally. So Gardevoir, Medicham, Grumpig, Lunatone, Claydol, and Zatu. How many is that?
Let's see here. So you said Gardevoir, Medicham, Claydol, Lunatone, and Grumpig? Yeah, that's 5.
Oh, one more. So Wobbuffet.
Like I said, I wouldn't use Wobbuffet. I mean, if you're gonna use a
different Girafarig, then?
Yeah.
Alright. I mean, at the very least, we could get Gardevoir early, then.
Yeah. Gardevoir would be the earliest, definitely, but it's also the hardest to find at only a mere 4% encounter rate.
Well, you know...
It is what it is, I guess.
Well, you know how lucky I've been.
Yeah, I know. Well, my question is, does it have to be male? Because if it does, it might take you longer.
I really don't think it matters, to be honest, because look at the appearance of Gardevoir. And...
No, but I'm just saying, I'm pretty sure that Gardevoir is 50-50, but its encounter rate is so low, you're more than likely gonna come across a,
hang on. And it's fine, hot dog. I'm doing good. You? Sorry about that. Go on. But yeah, what I'm saying is, like, judging by its appearance, I feel like it's more fitting as a female, personally. I'm sorry, but... Okay, you were saying, Usagi?
I was saying it's hard to find in the first place, so... I'm saying, don't be surprised if the one you find, you know...
Is female?
Yes.
I shouldn't be anyway, because... If it was... I just wait till Gen 4 if I wanted a male Ralts anyway, for obvious reasons. And I'm doing so in, with Platinum, yeah. So, if I wanted to get a male Ralts, that would be like post-Gen 4 for Gallade. For King Leonidas. Alright. Yeah, I guess a Psychic playthrough would do. But yeah, I will say this, once I start my Pokemon White 2 playthrough next week, I just hope I'm not playing. I'm thinking I'm playing black and the other black and white two, and not Pokemon White 2. This has been a running theme in this channel throughout this playthrough too.
You're not wrong, hot dog, but we're talking about monotype teams.
Yeah. Usagi, I think he's tempting me now.
I know. Well, I'm just saying, he's not wrong.
And if you want to go with best Gen 3, I'd say that's Duskull. And I mostly blame Warcraft 3 for that.
I'm just saying it's good. Like, it's a good option if you don't... Like, if you don't choose Sceptile yourself, it's actually a pretty good option.
I mean, if I wanted to choose Sceptile, I'd probably just switch Sceptile in Emerald in favor of Blaziken.
I'm just saying.
Plus, I was gonna get, like, Ludicolo in, Emerald, but unfortunately, May had it.
I know.
And also, another question, now that I think about it. Can Tropius learn Fly?
Yes.
So, that would be a perfect option, then. Replace, like, Sceptile for Blaziken in favor of Tropius.
Oh, no, I was talking about, like, on a mono team. You're talking about for Emerald. I mean, Tropius is okay, but it's not the best grass type in the region.
Well, should I just stick with, Sceptile in Gen, in Emerald?
Yeah, I would.
Alright. Because, I don't know, just having, like, an Altaria while... That's one of Wally's main Pokemon is kind of weird. And I could go with Swellow or whatever his name is. That's perfectly...
Swellow is pretty good, but I...
Oh, it's normal.
Yeah, that, and I think May might have one.
I mean, if we run out of options, like, well, almost we did in Hacker's Memory, because I just went with one of, like, the Frontier Digimons anyway. Dude, does it look like I have a choice in this game? Because last time I said no. Camera up for fire.
Who we picked as our fire type? We even did pick a fire type.
I think we had in my Ruby team, which is basically my main...
No, I'm talking about the Emerald team. I'm saying I thought we picked a fire type, but I don't remember if we did.
Let me check the doc. What is... Oh, that's the Dark Zone? Well, that's very nice of that lady. Let me check. Emerald? No, we don't have any fire types. We just have ground, water, grass, normal, ghost dark, rock bug, and dragon flying.
Oh yeah, then we're probably fine.
I was gonna say, if we can't find anyone else, we could always go with the Chris. I guess we could go with, like, Skarmory.
And yes, I've used Skarmory, it's really good.
Though it opens it opens another problem. What about Crystal, since Gen 2 is pretty lacking?
You mean in terms of flying types?
Yeah. Because we were already having trouble who to pick in, Crystal.
Yeah, we were. I recall that.
Yeah, we... Because I know my... Like, prior to you helping me out, I know my sister. What about Noctowl?
I mean, Noctowl's okay as long as you don't mind that it doesn't hit as hard.
Yeah, I like me some Noctowl, so it should be fine. Because I don't think, Gene has a Noctowl.
No, he doesn't. Okay. He has a Crobat.
Okay, so Noctowl it is. Can't believe Santa's canon. Well, too bad.
He's not wrong. There have been multiple Pokemon episodes with Santa in them.
Yeah, but I know the official Santa, isn't that great. I think it's considered one of the worst, actually. And by that, I'm talking about Delibird.
Well, yeah, but I'm referring to a actual human Santa who was in the Pokemon anime a few times. And had a Delibird as a helper, but no, I'm talking about Santa.
Ah, okay. I still wonder if that's all real, that NORAD has these little things where they're tracking Santa.
I have no idea.
I don't believe it. Okay, so we're getting to the 8th gym now. Wait, isn't, like, the Bat Santa basically Krampus or whatever his name is?
I have no idea. I've never seen that movie.
Well, it's not just a movie. I know it's sort of like a evil Santa Claus. Not like a Bat Santa like that one movie. Yeah, I guess Skarmory for Fly, like a flyer in Emerald, while Noctowl in Crystal.
Yeah.
Oh god, no, I just realized. Gramble! I want my Gramble!
Yeah, so...
That's... See what I mean? Like, Gen 2 is really lacking. That's the problem I have with Gen 2. Like, I know a lot of people praise the thing. Oh god, no Delibird. And my question is, can man... No, I can't. I don't think he can. Yeah, sorry if I'm distracted. I'm just, like, thinking. I can't... For a water flying type, he can't learn fly.
Who can't?
Mantine.
No, Mantine cannot.
What, Gyarados?
Gyarados can't learn fly either.
What is wrong with this gen?
I don't know.
Guess I'll stick with Skarmory second gen. Flyers are there. I know Mei has Pelipper. I highly doubt Ninjas could even learn Fly.
No. Too weak.
I mean, worst case scenario is, I guess we could stick with Tropius and switch Sceptile in favor of Blaziken. If that's okay with you.
I mean, you don't have to.
I don't mind.
Wait a minute, that's it.
What's up?
You could use Doduo.
Didn't we just use him in Yellow?
Maybe? I don't know.
Yeah, we used Doldrio, you know, Watermelon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so,
Wait a sec. Really hate the remake version of Maya. I really hate to see it every single time. Oh god, get that thing away from me. And oh, come on, May!
What?
You know what? Since May isn't as prominent as Wally, let's just stick with... Wait, Mudkip? Wait, Blaziken, Torchic. Okay. I guess I could use Pelipper.
Yeah.
Nice.
That means we're gonna have to give up Altaria, though.
Yeah, and Whiscash as well, but that would lead to like a potential six replacement.
Mhm.
Oh man, at least that helped. And at least I know who to raid after I head to town. Or at least defeat Bianca. Yeah, because that gets rid of, like, Whiscash and Altaria.
Yeah. But now this means we have to pick something else.
And we get rid of Sceptile, too, for in favor of Blaziken. Cause now, now Hot Dog has really inspired me to do, like, a pure grass type playthrough. No, seriously, Bianca, why'd you have to take this doggo? I wanted that doggo! That's all I could say. Yeah, there's
because
a-
just because?
Because what?
Just because.
Yeah, why I say that? Because I have a rule set in my Pokemon playthroughs that I don't pick any of the Pokemon that the rival has. Yeah, a little slash will do- Bruh! Oh, you did not just do that, Bianca. No, it doesn't. Dark type? I don't really think like Hoenn has many dark types, though. Let me check.
Some, let's see, it has Mightyena.
Yeah, Mightyena, Crawdaw, yeah, Absol, Shiftry, but that's Ruby exclusive.
Ruby exclusive, yes.
There's Sableye, which is like, that makes it three. Carvana, which is Torpedo.
Torpedo.
Oh, that's a full six right there.
Cacturn.
Yeah, that's a full six right there.
Speaking of, if you want a grass type on the team, why not use Cacturn?
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, honestly, at the end of the day, I love almost every Pokemon from Hoenn anyway, because... like I said, Gen 3 fanboyism. Did a staple, like a staple, get on my shoe?
Don't ask me.
Yeah, good thing I just got it off, because that would be unpleasant.
You think?
Oh, that's a... yep, back... no, wait, I could just use... no, wait. Yeah. Let's take the risk and use Archie Bunker against him. Those were the days. About to use Marsh. etc. Rock types are underwhelming to me. Why do you say that? Because I know Aggron is a pretty good rock type. And steel as well.
Type.
Yeah, you know, steel rock.
Yeah. We're gonna be using... Armaldo. Now that's rock.
Yeah. So at least we got that flying issue figured out.
Yep.
Finally.
Yes, Shuckle is a rock type. Bug rock, but yeah, it's a rock type.
And I know it isn't too great either.
Well, in the modern games, you can kind of get around it by using power swap.
Right. Okay, we get it, Bianca.
Does, right? No.
No, I don't think so myself.
What Power Swap does is it swaps the attack.
No, I'm talking about Hot Dog's message about Shuckle, the best Gen 2 Pokemon.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were talking about...
No. If you say so. You know, to be honest, now I think about it, I don't know, even know if I really have a favorite in Gen 2.
As I started to say, what Power Swap does...
Okay.
...is it,
I'll let you think about it.
Basically, what Power Swap does is it swaps the attack and special attack stats with the defense and special defense stats. So because Shuckle has a ridiculously high defense, if you swap out its low attack with its high defense... ...
Yeah?
Well, let's just say you're not going to be laughing anymore.
And also, yeah, okay, that one's good. I'm not going to lie about that. Well, that's post-game, though.
Yeah, it kind of stinks that you can't even get one before the post-game because one of the Rocket Executives has one.
Yeah.
If you're not careful, it can totally,
Yeah, I don't really care for that, to be honest.
What?
Scizor.
I mean, Scizor's not bad, but it requires a lot of extra prep work.
Yeah, and you also need to trade a Scyther with Seal Cult for it to evolve, too.
That's what I said. Prep work. Because right. While it is possible to get multiple metal coats, the only way you can get a metal coat before the post-game is by farming Magnemite.
Ah, okay.
Dunsparce has a really big problem. Like, it's a cool looking Pokemon, but its stats just do not help it.
See, he's talking about Dunsparce?
Yes.
Yeah, that's why I'm saying, like, as a lot of people say, Gen 2 is pretty great, but honestly, from what I'm seeing, it just feels pretty underwhelming, now that I think about it.
Well, that's because wasn't Gen 3 your first?
No, actually, it was Gen 1. Then I took my sister's, like, copy of, Blue, because I really wanted to play it as a kid, but she wouldn't share, because she already had Red. And, yeah, I just took it as my own, and I went from there. And then finally, she was generous enough to give me her copy of Gold. Then I got Gen 3, and it's obviously one of my favorite games ever.
Yeah, you might have liked it better if you actually got it sooner, but hey, she decided she didn't want to share.
Right. I mean, she's still like that to this day anyway.
Because I played Gen 2, you know, during the, you know, I played Gen 2 when it was actually... Oh, what's the word I'm looking for? Like, when it was actually still ongoing.
Right.
So this would have been like 2000, 2001. I was playing Gen 2 around that time, and you know, that at that point, you know, we didn't really care
On Hot Dog's message, you were saying?
Yes.
No, I was... What were you saying about Gen 2?
I said I was playing it, you know, 2000, 2001, when the games, you know, when Gold, Silver... You know, Gold and Silver came out in 2000, and Gold and, you know, Crystal came out in 2001. I was actually playing Gen 2 then. So, yeah, I mean... It, you know, like, little things like that didn't bother me because Gen 3 wasn't even out yet.
I guess, but you look at it in a retrospective, yeah.
Well, why do you think they added the Safari Zone in HeartGold and SoulSilver,
I mean, I've heard a lot of good things about the remakes.
Well, I'm just saying. Well, Fire Red is considered Gen 3, but it is a Gen 1 remake.
Yeah. So, for the mono...
To make the long story short, it does count as Gen 3.
Alright. So, for the mono challenge in Sapphire... So, well, obviously... Oh, man, now I'm really debating. Do I go with Grass or Psychic?
I mean... Either way, you have a lot of options.
Well, I wanted to go with, like, Psychic, because, I mean, look at my avatar.
Yeah. Well,
but why were you saying Dark,
though? The reason I was... Black Mage, get it?
Oh! Oh, man, now you really got me tempted to start with a Mightyena. Or Mightyena.
Well, I'm just saying, and that's what, you know, that's what my brain automatically went to.
Would make a lot more sense if it was like Dark Psychic or something.
Well, the only Dark Psychic types that I know of are not in Generation 3 at all.
Well, obviously. So, if we were gonna compare Final Fantasy jobs in, as Pokemon types, obviously I know Warrior, would it be like, Fighting and Steel?
Probably. I mean, I'm sorry, it's just, you know, Dark was the first thing I thought of when you said, you know.
Well, I guess that makes a lot more sense, and there's plenty to pick from anyway. So, Mightyena is obviously my first choice.
That the thing about the only problem is it's going to.
Going to what?
Like, the thing about the dark type is most of the dark types are physical attackers, so. And they're, you know, they're. Like, they're physical attackers, but, you know, dark was a special type back then, so. Yeah, that's gonna hurt.
Well, at least I'm paying attention here and there, but I'm just so into the other one. Ah, I see. Yeah, I know a lot of people like Emerald a lot more than the originals.
In some ways, it was harder and more obnoxious. Take the Tate and Liza fight, for example.
In the original?
No, in Emerald.
Oh, okay. So there was a little challenge there. I mean, I had Emerald as a kid, but of course, even before, like, our little falling out throughout the 2010s, she would always take the games I play, even though I tell her no. So, there's that. Because obviously, I did buy Emerald at one point as well. Ah, I see. Not the truth. So should I just go with Psychic then?
I mean, you do what you feel is the best choice.
It's usually when I think of like magic type, if there was like a magic type, it's definitely Psychic.
Yeah, well, I was thinking about the fact that, you know, the black mages use the more offensive spells.
Right. If black mages are dark and psychic, would that mean white mages are fairy and psychic?
More like grass and psychic, probably.
Oh, okay.
Get it? Because grass types use a lot of healing moves.
Oh, yeah, that makes a lot more sense. What about red mages then? I know the obvious is psychic. Normal psychic?
Maybe.
Cause you know they're like a jack of all trades.
Yeah.
And normal is like that too.
Yep.
I think we all, I guess warrior and, yeah, warrior would be like steel fighting, right?
Probably.
Monk would also, would be,
probably pure fighting.
Oh, yeah. How about thief, even though we don't use thieves at all? Dark?
No. Maybe. I want to say maybe electric type because of how fast they are?
Probably, yeah. I never seen. Or what about magic missile? Cause I know that's a common spell in D&D. Mm-hmm. But yeah, as for psychic, so I'd go with Gardevoir since she's early.
Yep.
Medicham, cause I don't want to use like Alakazam, cause I don't know if this thing's capable of trading, like local
well,
trading.
Well, here's the thing: you can turn on impossible trades, and it'll just evolve by level up that way. It's just a thought.
I know.
But if that's not your thing, then don't bother.
All right, but yeah, as for other psychics, it'll be Grumpig, obviously. Yeah. we'll get Wilbur back. So Lunatone, Claydol. Yeah, that's like 5, I think. So 6-1 would be... I'd go with Zatu as well. For the little guy, for the guy to fly us around. I don't know, to be honest. I think I'll do the last gym next month, because I'm like really distracted by this whole conversation. If that's okay, Usagi.
Yeah. Raisin? Not really. Like, the closest would be Cherubi, but that's not even a raisin.
Isn't that like a cherry?
Yeah. Well, I'm just saying, he asked if there was a raisin Pokemon yet, and
yeah.
There isn't.
I saw. But yeah. But yeah, that's it for Pokemon White 1, you guys. I'll continue this on February, because you guys know my computer has been acting up. But, come on with the Discord messages. Okay, but yeah. As always, tomorrow I'll be doing the first half of Great Bay. Assuming I don't get that done before I start Great Bay Temple. So yeah, more Majora's Mask at the first half of Great Bay. Yeah. Great Bay. Anyway, yeah. Rating, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.